As we gather at your table, as we listen to your word, help us know, O God, your presence. Let our hearts and minds be stirred. Nourish us with sacred story, till we claim it as our own. Teach us through this holy banquet how to make love's victory known. Turn our worship into witness in the sacrament of life. Send us forth to love and serve you, bringing peace where there is strife. Give us, Christ, your great compassion, to forgive as you forgave. May we still behold your image in the world you died to save.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess, Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, and what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Glory to God in the high. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who manifest your almighty power above all by pardoning and showing mercy, bestow, we pray, your grace abundantly upon us, and make those hastening to attain your promises heirs to the treasures of heaven. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the Book of Numbers. The Lord came down in the cloud and spoke to Moses. Taking some of the spirit that was on Moses, the Lord bestowed it on the 70 elders. And as the spirit came to rest on them, they prophesied. Now two men, one named Eldad and the other Medad, were not in the gathering, but had been left in the camp. They too had been on the list, but had not gone out to the tent. Yet the Spirit came to rest on them also, and they prophesied in the camp. So when a young man quickly told Moses, Eldad and Medad are prophesying in the camp, Joshua, son of Nun, who from his youth had been Moses' aide, said, Moses, my Lord, stop them. But Moses answered him, Are you jealous for my sake? Would that all the people of the Lord were prophets. Would that the Lord might bestow his spirit on all of them. The word of the Lord.
Precepts of the Lord give joy to the heart. The precepts of the Lord give joy to the heart. The law of the Lord is perfect, refreshing the soul. The decree of the Lord is trustworthy, giving wisdom to the simple. The fear of the Lord is pure, enduring forever. The ordinances of the Lord are true, all of them just. The precepts of the Lord give joy to the heart. Though your servant is careful of them, very diligent in keeping them, yet who can detect failings? Cleanse me from my unknown faults. From wanton sin especially restrain your servant. Let it not rule over me. Then shall I be blameless and innocent of serious sin. The precepts of the Lord give joy to the heart.
A reading from the letter of St. James. Come now, you rich, weep and wail over your impending miseries. Your wealth has rotted away. Your clothes have become moth-eaten. Your gold and silver have corroded, and that corrosion will be a testimony against you. It will devour your flesh like a fire. You have stored up treasure for the last days. Behold, the wages you withheld from the workers who harvested your fields are crying aloud, and the cries of the harvesters have reached the ears of the Lord of hosts. You have lived on earth in luxury and pleasure. You have fattened your hearts for the day of slaughter. You have condemned. You have murdered the righteous one. He offers you no resistance. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Your words, O Lord, is truth. Consecrate us in the truth. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. At that time, John said to Jesus, "Teacher, we saw someone driving out demons in your name, and we tried to prevent him because he does not follow us." Jesus replied, "Do not prevent him. There is no one who performs a mighty deed in my name who can at the same time speak ill of me. For whoever is not against us is for us. Anyone who gives you a cup of water to drink because you belong to Christ, a man, I say to you, will surely not lose his reward. Whoever causes one of these little ones who believe in me to sin, it would be better for him if a great millstone were put around his neck and he were thrown into the sea. If your hand causes you to sin, cut it off. It is better for you to enter into life maimed than go with two hands into Gehenna, into the unquenchable fire. And if your foot causes you to sin, cut it off. It is better for you to enter into life crippled than with two feet to be thrown into Gehenna. And if your eye causes you to sin, pluck it out. Better for you to enter into the kingdom of God with one eye and with two eyes to be thrown into Gehenna, where their worm does not die and the fire is not quenched." The Gospel of the Lord. A man was hired as a security guard in a big office building downtown. And on his first day, he was working with a much older guard who was at the end of his career there, retiring. And as he sat there, kind of picking up all the tricks of the job, he noticed that every once in a while, a very panicked-looking person would come down the elevator, crutching a computer and a stack of papers, and kind of sprint out of the building. And every time it happened, the older security guard would just kind of giggle to himself. And after a couple of times, he came up to him and said, "You have to tell me what's going on. Do people keep running out of this building all the time?" And he said, No. "Today's my last day, so I thought I'd make it memorable. So a little while ago, I started calling random numbers in the building. And anyone who picked up, I would just say, 'I don't know who talked, but the authorities know everything and they're on their way.' And then I would hang up the phone. And I've been just watching them run out in panic ever since." A lot of people have something on their conscience. Some people allow jealousy to really take over, like Joshua did, or like the apostles did when they wanted to stop someone from doing something good because they felt like it was making them become less special. Or they let greed take root in their heart, like St. James was warning us about in our second reading. So that in their lives they started to try to use people to serve their love for money, as opposed to using their money to serve their love of people, like we're supposed to. But this could be true of all sorts of other sins as well. Could be sins of hatred or of lust, sins of gluttony or laziness. But if we're honest with ourselves, I think we all recognize that there is some part of us that is drawn to things we know aren't right. Some part of us that is affected by original sin is drawing us away from God and towards some sort of selfishness, some sort of division, of evil. And Jesus takes that very seriously. He doesn't want us to ignore that. He doesn't want us to just say, well, you know, oh well. He speaks of it. He speaks about it in very strong terms. He compares it as being, it's being worse than having a heavy stone tied to us before we're thrown into the sea. He says it's less bad, it's more, that sin is worse than losing a hand or an eye. That's very strong language. He wants us to know that sin is a big deal, that sin damages what's truly valuable, what's eternal. Damages our relationship with God, damages our relationships with each other, damages the state of our soul. And he wants us to take that very seriously. But even more importantly, what he wants us to take even more seriously is his mercy. Because the goal isn't to focus on the sin. The goal is to recognize the sin, to reject it, to turn away from it, and to embrace God's healing power. When Jesus wants us to take sin seriously and make sure that we are avoiding sin in our own lives and doing everything we can to keep from being the cause of others' sin, he's not doing it because he wants us to be over-focused on it. He's doing it because he knows how much that damages us. He wants us to be free. And so he gives us the fountains of grace to make it possible to be free of that sin. He makes sure that we have access to his mercy, that we can turn to him, that we can ask for forgiveness, that we can receive the grace we need to be converted and sin no more. And then a great one of those is the sacrament of confession. In this moment, we're able to come to Christ, to acknowledge our sins, and by doing that, to let go of them, to offer them up, so that Christ can take them, unite them to his cross, and then give us the freedom of absolution. He wants us to be able to let that sin disappear, to be destroyed. And in exchange, to receive the grace we need to make better choices in the future, to not fall into that sin again. And so it's so important that we really take advantage of that great gift of God's mercy, that we recognize the places in our hearts where we are still being drawn to impatience or dishonesty, to selfishness, to jealousy, to greed, to whatever sins we might feel we are struggling with. Ask for God's help. Make sure that we are turning away from those temptations as early as possible, that we're not putting ourselves or anyone else into temptation, but that we recognize that we need to be battling against sin. We need to be struggling to build up the virtue and break any bad habits. But also that God's mercy is always available, because we will not be perfect in this life. And God doesn't expect us to be. He's not telling us that we have to overcome sin in order to be able to come to Him. Quite the opposite. He's telling us that we have to come to Him so that He can set us free of our sin by uniting it to the cross on which He has overcome sin already. And so let's never lose hope, because we're meant to take sin seriously. But much more importantly, we're meant to accept God's mercy and take that completely seriously. No matter what we have done, no matter what we are fighting against, that we can always come to Christ. We can always bring it to confession. We can always be washed free by the flood of His mercy. Let us strive to live our lives according to His love, so that no matter what we hear, the authorities have found out, we are not in a panic, because through God's grace, we are living lives we can be proud of.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God. Begotten, not made, consubstantial of the Father, through Him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake He was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and His kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. And now, knowing that God is always there with us, and trusting in His power and mercy, we turn to Him with confidence as we bring forward our petitions.
That all chosen to lead our church do so with loving compassion and service. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. That those in government service regard all human life with sacred respect. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. that people who feel their life has no meaning receive understanding and loving care. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That victims of all manner of abuse find the courage to share their stories and are able to get the help of empathetic advocates. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we hold in prayer all members of our faith community, especially those who are unable to join us at Christ's table. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the recently departed of our collaborative, Christine Elliott, Raphael Bruisi, Joan Polito, James Franey, Nancy Melidi, and Jason LeClaire, that they be welcomed into God's kingdom and embraced by God our Father in heaven. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray in a special way for Barbara L. Condon's 100th birthday, Adelina Sequeira, Carolina Canuto, deceased members of St. Vincent de Paul, John Cole Green's 16th anniversary, and for our country that we are one nation under God, for whom masses this weekend are being offered. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord God, we thank you for hearing us. And trusting in your presence, we strive to turn to you with all our needs. And we ask you to set us free from sin and help us to grow into the saints we were created to be. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Whatsoever you do to the least of my people, that you do unto me. When I was hungry, you gave me to eat. When I was thirsty, gave me to drink. Now enter into the home of my Father. Whatsoever you do to the least of my people, that you do unto me. When I was homeless, you opened your door. When I was naked, you gave me your coat. Now enter into the home of my Father. Whatsoever you do to the least of my people, that you do unto me. When I was weary, you helped me find rest. When I was anxious, you calmed all my fears. Now enter into the home of my Father. Whatsoever you do to the least of your people that you do unto me.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Grant us, O merciful God, that this, our offering, may find acceptance with you, and that through it the wellspring of all blessing may be laid open before us, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in you we live and move and have our being. And while in this body, we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in his paschal mystery. And so with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration, we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread. And giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Wow. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Sean, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us, Lamb of God. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us, Lamb of God. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us, grant us peace. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Says it can be, change our minds this time. Your life could make us free. We are the people your call set apart, Lord, this time. Change our hearts. Brought by your hand to the edge of our dreams, one foot in paradise, one in the waste. Drawn by your promises, still we are lured by the shadows and the chains we leave behind. But change our hearts this time. Your word says it can be. Change our minds this time. Your life could make us free. We are the people your call set apart, Lord, this time. Change our hearts. Now as we watch, you stretch out your hands, offering abundance is fullness of joy. Your milk and honey seem distant, unreal, when we have bread and water in our hands. But change our hearts this time. Your word says it can be. Change our minds this time. Your life could make us free. We are the people your call set apart, Lord, this time. Change our hearts.
Let us pray. May this heavenly mystery, O Lord, restore us in mind and body, that we may be co-heirs in glory with Christ, to whose suffering we are united whenever we proclaim his death, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Glory and praise to our God, who alone gives light to our days. Many are the blessings he bears to those who trust in his ways. We, the daughters and sons of him who built the valleys and plains, praise the wonders our God has done in every heart that sings. Glory and praise to our God, who alone gives light to our days. Many are the blessings he bears to those who trust in his ways. In his wisdom he strengthens us like gold that's tested in fire. Though the power of sin prevails, our God is there to save. Glory and praise to our God, who alone gives light to our days. Many are the blessings he bears to those who trust in his ways.